There's a moment in your bones when the fire takes over. Blood is running, heart is pumping as the battle gets closer. They can say what they want now, 'cause we'll be screaming out. We can be heroes everywhere we go. We can have all that we ever want. Swinging like Ali, decking out bodies, standing on top like a champion. Keep your silver, give me that gold. You'll remember when I say we can be heroes everywhere we go. Keeping us down is impossible, 'cause we're unstoppable. Every spotlight, every soundbite, everybody who gave up is just a fuel for wanting him more than anybody against us. They can say what they want now, 'cause we'll be screaming now. We can be heroes everywhere we go. We can have all that we ever want.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to another production from Cheyenne Mustang Media. We are excited that you are joining us on our first and final stop of the Cheyenne Mustang Media World Tour. As tonight, we are pleased to bring you the first round of the EDC tournament between the West Fargo Cheyenne Mustangs, who will be the visitors on the scoreboard against the home team, the Fargo North Spartans. My name is Jordan Latovsky. Joining me tonight is going to be Sean Burke. And Sean, if history has shown us anything, I think all indications point to tonight being a very tightly contested game and a very competitive game. And what other way would you start the postseason off?
I want so tight. I want it to go down to the wire.
Well, if you're looking at games of the past between these two teams, and I know that's part of our pregame show that,
a little foreshadowing,
that we
yeah.
will talk about, yes. But, you know, tonight certainly what I would expect would prove to be absolutely no different. So if we look a little bit about our EDC tournament and our pregame show here, in the two playing games, Devils Lake defeated Grafton Park River 3-1. So Devils Lake comes in as the 8 seed. Grafton was the 9. They were defeated. And then Davies with a very convincing 6-0 win
yes.
over Mayport. They actually outshot them 67-5. So Davies scored more goals than gave up shots. And if you're Coach Metcalf, you certainly love that defensive
yeah.
Posturing by your opponent, by your Davies Eagles. So looking at the bracket here,
we have got some phenomenal matchups tonight.
Yeah, the first round, you have Grand Forks Red River against Devils Lake. Red River swept the Firebirds in the regular season by a score of 6-1 and also 5-1. And then the one matchup, that had a split during the regular season is that 4-5 game that is taking place over at Farmers Union Arena tonight. During the regular season, West Fargo got a win 4-3. Fargo South got a win 4-1, and that Fargo South win, I believe, Sean, was after the game that we did
right.
Against West Fargo. In the 2-7 matchup, you have Grand Forks Central comes in number 2 overall, Fargo Davies number 7 in the regular season. Grand Forks Central swept Fargo Davies 4-1 and then 7-0. And then in this game here, the 3-6, you have North and Cheyenne. Two very, very close games. You had a 1-0 win by Fargo North at the Coliseum.
Yeah.
And then just about a month later, a little over a month later, you had a 3-2 Fargo North win at the West Fargo Sports Arena. So you look at the matchups tonight, Sean, I think this matchup and then that 4-5 between West Fargo and Fargo South, those are going to be two very pivotal games and two very close games.
Right. I'd like to be at both, but hopefully we can maybe catch that, but I don't know.
Well, thank goodness we're here.
Let's just be focused
yes,
on this.
Yes, and we got set up here at the Coliseum. We appreciate the
super sweet setup.
It is. It's very nice, and it's warm, too.
I know.
A little worried about that, but we have great temp to broadcast the high school hockey game with. We're right on top of the action. So looking at our keys to tonight's game, and Sean, I'm going to let you kind of commandeer this a little bit here because
right.
I know that you
so
had a certain theme to it.
Right. We're playing North, right? I'm going to go with one of the more underappreciated bands from Canada. still rocking it. It is Backman Turner Overdrive, one of their in Canada underappreciated hits. We're going with number one right here, looking out for number one.
Yeah, we see that the Mustangs, they fell victim to North's number one line in that last game, scoring all three goals in that number one line for Fargo North. There's going to be, Sean, there's going to be some coaches from opposing teams that are going to go to Fargo North's graduation in the spring to make sure that it's true that those guys graduated. Yeah. Owen Branson, he's got 115 career points. Ray Wallen, 101. And then Max Watson, that formidable top line, they're a very, very offensive.
That's 250-plus points.
Yes.
On one line. So you have got to know where they are on the ice at all times.
And even scarier is when you get them out there with the man advantage,
yeah.
Because they – you talk, Sean, about players knowing where each other are and playing with each other. This group's been with each other for a while. Very good on the power play. North kind of runs that unique power play. Not really unique anymore, I don't think. You see it more and more with kind of that bumper right in the middle, and they're very, very effective.
We are talking skill, and was noticeable last game, speed. And that's a lethal combination. You've got to know where they're on the ice at all times, and that's what we got to do a little better job of this game. Number two, taking care of business.
Now you talk about underappreciated band there. That's the only song of theirs that I know, but I absolutely love that. And business starts in the defensive zone. Everybody loves to play in the offensive zone, but you can't play in the offensive zone if you're lax in the D zone. You know, Cheyenne does have a very good goaltender in Jaden Beater. He's going to come in tonight. He's going to be the starter. He's got an 88 save percentage. He's very capable, but you don't want to make his life any more difficult than you have to.
Right.
And so it's and it can't just be the defenseman either. It's got to be all five working in unison.
Right. I think eliminate dangerous scoring positions. You know, sometimes, you know, like we've seen, we get 60 shots, but how many of those you're going were quality scoring chances? And with that North, with that number one line, that is going to be something we have got to pay attention to, something that has been noticeable the last two games. And but wasn't it Hit in America, this song? You ain't seen nothing yet. Baby, you ain't seen nothing
I
yet.
I lied. I just didn't know. I didn't know that they sang it.
All right.
Unfortunately, I see that we have a little typo in there. The shortest road to state starts with tonight. Now, the shortest, I guess, way to spell state is to take the first T out. But you have to go out there and play like there's no tomorrow. Now,
right.
Sean, this group of seniors, we talked about it before, they have elevated the program here at Cheyenne. They've entered the last two state tournaments. Last year is the best finish they've had in program history.
Right.
On the flip side of it, and you talk about a team that has been right on the cusp and close and close and close. Let's roll the calendar back about 4 years.
Man.
2020
yes.
For Fargo North.
Yep.
They end their season with a 4-3, two overtime loss to Grand Forks Central in a state qualifier. Okay, two overtimes there. Next year, 2021, in a loser out game, a 4-3 loss, again, two overtimes to West Fargo. So you're now looking four overtimes. 2022, 3-2 loss to Red River, who was the eventual state champion, and a two overtime loss, again, state qualifier. And then last year, they had a four overtime loss, 2-1 to Fargo Davies in a state qualifier. So three out of the last 4 years, they've at least played a minimum of two overtimes in a state qualifier and haven't come out on top. So you're talking about a team.
That is cruel.
That can almost just taste it. And I know that this group of seniors we talked about for Fargo North, you have Branson, you have Wall and Watson. I mean, we've said these names, Kellbrenner, you know, throughout the lineup. They've had success on the football field. We know that they won state football. They've had success. You know, a lot of these players, you know, were on the baseball team that Cheyenne beat in the state championship,
yeah.
The soccer team.
Golf.
There's a good group of athletes here just on the rink. They haven't been able to, you know, they've been knocking on the door. They just haven't been invited into the party, so to speak.
And I think what you just shared with myself and everyone else has not gone unnoticed with that crew.
I know, I'm sure, even if we talk about those seniors, I'm sure that is on their mind, that your senior year is always kind of the group they look back to, and it's this player's year and this player's year, and they say the last name, and they want to be the group that can get North over that maybe psychological hump a little bit. So
yeah, you got to figure that the psychological. I'm glad you touched upon that. You know, because you, from what we've seen, they've got the physical traits, right?
Absolutely.
They've got the chemistry, but yeah, you know, tighter the game, and look at those for the last 4 years. is that, you know, I do not want to be the one to make that error. But on the flip side, it's like I want to be the one to make the difference, to put us over that hump.
Absolutely. And you talk about some names of players that were on those teams, the Frittles, Hallquists, Dorschers, the goaltenders they've had. They've been so dang close.
Yeah, Mr. Robeson, I see him.
Yes,
at the
Ryan
rink.
Robeson, yes.
Yeah.
So I think if you look at this bracket here, I think the prognosticators out there would look at that game against Red River and Devil's Lake. I think they're probably looking at Red River in that one, and then that game against Central Davies. These two, the 4-5 games, South and West Fargo, and the 6-3 between Cheyenne and North, I think those are toss-ups. They can go either way.
Yeah, absolutely. That's why I'm so excited that, you know, I wish it was staggered a bit. The one was a little earlier, and we can maybe catch both. But, hey, I'm just pumped to be here and being able to cover this. So.
And we've said it the last number of years that we've been doing game shows, Sean, excuse me, whatever you pay to get into this EDC tournament, it's gonna be, it's gonna be well worth it. So if you like watching live hockey and you like being entertained,
I don't know what you're doing here,
but we're fortunate and we're glad that you're with us. If you are able, we hope that you can get up to Perp Arena on Friday and Saturday.
Yes.
It'll be what, the 16th and 17th, because you will be thoroughly entertained. So I think with that, we'll take a short break for our national anthem, and then we'll rejoin you for our first period.
Hi, I'm Micah, and I work at Marvin. I've been in the military for 8 years. I was a preventive medicine technician in the U.S. Navy, and so that translated over to working at Marvin and how can safety help make Marvin a better company. The culture working at Marvin is probably the best one I've worked with, other than being in the military. Working together and caring about each other, you feel like you're part of the family at Marvin. Come work with me at Marvin. It's a great place to work.
Hi, I'm Christian, and I work at Marvin. My military background is the basis of who I am. I was looking for something to help me be the Marine who wasn't a Marine anymore. Belonging to Marvin feels like I'm part of something. I know that being with Marvin means I'm making a difference in every homeowner's life, because the windows, skylights, and doors that I'm helping to build. Come work with me at Marvin. I think you'll enjoy it.
Fans, welcome back to the West Fargo Sports Arena. Sean, this is unique for us. We broadcast all our games from the West Fargo Sports Arena inside a room behind panes of glass. We're right in the mix here. The energy is palpable.
We are in with the throngs. I feel a little more comfortable that we are closer to the Cheyenne fans than we are the North fans.
I think the North fans are friendly folks. I know you know many of them.
In case things happen.
Yes, yeah. So it is, and one of the things I hope that fans that are here do see is what our producers do and what our camera people do. I mean, there's tables spread out here. We got, I believe it's four cameras here. This is a whole operation that we've taken on the road, and I say we, being Mustang Media, really, you and I show up at 6 o'clock,
yep,
and we get to watch it.
Put our makeup on and both smile for the cameras.
Yes, and so hopefully the fans notice that. Now, Sean, during the year, your regular season is kind of like your lesson plans, to put it in kind of education. Now it's time to take the test. You've been doing everything all year, all your practices, trying to find your line combinations. Cheyenne, they have been bit by the injury bug a little bit. One note is we do see Cooper Klaus is going to enter back into the Cheyenne lineup tonight.
Yeah, that is big.
He does lead them on the air with 31 points. He's got 12 goals and 19 assists.
Yes. All right, the music is pumped. The crowd is pumped. We're pumped. We're underway. Let's go. Mustangs win the draw, but nice knockdown at center ice by the number one line, the B-dub line, I've just christened it, with Branson, Wallen, and Watson. All right. Mustangs looking to get out of their own zone here. Big big hit. Christensen able to make the play. Mustangs looking to get this out. They are going to take it up. A little space in the center. Going to shoot that in, and they're going to change early on. 30-second shifts. High flipper off the glove of Christensen. He's going to get it and put that right back in. Mr. Parker Dosh, no surprise there. Start. Oh, almost just off the stick. Almost a nice bounce for the Mustangs there early on. All right. Spartans looking to bring this in. Oh, a little room. High slot, but couldn't negotiate the pass. Back to the point. Top of the circle. Oh, tried to go between the legs there. Gonna have to play a little safer than that. Oh, watch out. Right in the hands of Cooper Klaus in his first game back. We don't want to see that.
That was Bennett Benson there.
Oh, that was Bennett Benson.
All
right, sorry.
In his orange jerseys.
I saw the seven. Yeah. Saw him on the ice. Sorry, Mr. Bennett Benson. I'm glad to see everyone's all right, though. Oh, off the glove. A little dangerous there on that shot. That was Porter.
Beam.
Beam. Don't want to make that mistake. All right. Little feeling out process here right now. Good stick lift there on this right-hand side. Oh, nice. Almost a good, nice little dish there. All right. Mustangs closing the distance on that one. Oh, almost a hit from behind. Little shot. Ooh. Oh, good glove.
Yeah, Lashofsky got physical on the wall
yes.
there. We'll see it right almost here on our replays. The puck is going to come up, and he lays a body check right there. Yeah, it is close to the boards. Or he laid that on. That
you
was
don't like seeing that. That's
that Brigman, maybe?
A body.
Amundsen?
He kind of turned, so it wasn't malicious.
But he makes a nice play then to get the puck over to Meyer.
Right.
You mentioned Cooper Klaus in his first shift back. He was noticeable, stripped the puck from the North defenseman.
Oh!
Opportunity right in front there.
Yes.
Yeah. Klaus looked good on that first shift back. You like to see that if you're a Mustang fan.
Absolutely, yeah. All right. Oh, nice little dangle. That is Wallen showing the sweet mitts that we know he has. All right. North able to keep this in. Wallen from the right side. Drifts that one. Good one off a stick.
Our two goal
to the right of Beater.
Two goaltenders tonight. You just mentioned Beater. We'll go with him first. 88 save percentage. 2.8 goals against average. Record of 4-7. He's split time in the nets this year with Brock Berm. And for Fargo North, Parker Dosh. About 92 save percentage, 1.87 goals against. Comes into the record at 13-5.
All right, looks like we got Walden and Meyer lining up for this draw. I'm going to call that one a draw. On the draw. Floating up. Good timing pass on that one. Oh, nice little move there. Couldn't quite. Jack Pitts just kind of ran out of real estate. North defense staying with him. A shot from well out.
Maddox Watson, he made a nice play right there on Pitts.
Yeah.
Looked like Pitts was going to go in all alone, but Watson made a nice play at the very last second to lift his stick, and North goes up the other way, and Branson gets a shot right on Beater and up into the netting.
Yes, sir. Man, with the music, we are. If you're not into the game here, I can feel the reverberation right here. It's like, yo!
Well, it's playoff hockey now, Sean.
Yeah, we're gonna turn it to 11. All right, nice win by North on that draw. Mustangs are looking to bring this up on this left-hand side. They are able to get this out. That's Trace Meyer gonna come up here, looking for someone in the slot. Cannot find him. Nice job closing the lanes by North. Shot from the point. Oh. Good look at that one.
That was a nice play by Lashofsky. He sees Man Weber up at the point. Lashofsky goes from one corner to the
I think Weber's trying to hang on to it just for a second to try and get some traffic in front. But the only
he was.
Only people I could see in front were the two North
Rather see
defenders.
That shot right off the pads, though, right? I mean,
yeah.
Obviously,
yeah.
He doesn't whistle it off the glass.
Good job.
Nice shot there.
Oh.
Opportunity.
Wow.
Same thing there with Estebo. Smart defenseman gets a shot down low.
I think it went off the toe and not the pad, so he was expecting this puck to kind of get further out. He watches when it just kind of hung under the pad, so the dangerous spot there turned into a quality opportunity. All right, 13:35 remaining in a scoreless first period. All right, Mustangs trying to get that in deep for the second effort. Behind the back pass and the slot there. They're going to say no icing on that one. Mustangs going to be able to try. Oh, nice bat
play
down there.
Wow, Wyshowski.
Good hands. Oh.
Yeah, Wyshowski right at the blue end right there. I don't know if we'll pick it up on it. Yeah, right there.
So nice.
Tips it right to himself and gets it to Iverson.
And we had two North players that were just kind of licking their chops thinking that if that puck drops.
Right.
Probably go 2-on-1, and it couldn't tell if there's going to be a backdoor opportunity available in that one or not.
A little difference in numbers here. We see Johnson with 34 instead of his customary 12.
Yeah. And speaking of different, that line combination, Cooper Klaus, Johnson, and Benson are still together. Oh, nice block there by Christensen, not allowing Mr. Wallen to get the shot off. Going back to the point. Oh, could not hold it in. That was Maddox walked and losing the handle. All right, gonna tag up. There we go. Dylan Johnson, smart play there. Wait for his line mate to get onside. All right, Mustangs looking to bring this up. Not a lot of room there. Oh, a little strip. And that's Ray Wallen with the strip. Shot. Oh, Beater came out nice to challenge that, but that is not the guy you want to lose the puck to. 12:22 remaining. Shot from the point. Looking for a deflection there. No one there for the Spartans. All right. Puck cut off. Gained at the line. Hogging the line there. Oh, off an ankle. Good job because that puck did not hold. Oh, sloppy play. Oh, there's no one there for. Yeah, we got lucky
Cheyenne,
on that one.
Cheyenne was fortunate there that North went for a change because they turned the puck over twice in their own zone. And the second one there, there's only two North players, obviously all five Cheyenne guys. They couldn't go for a change, but they got to take care of the puck a little bit better in their defensive zone. Jayden Beater bailed them out there.
Yeah, absolutely.
Estebo fumbled with it. Maddox Watson, as you mentioned, not the guy you want with that opportunity.
No. And that was one of the keys is that, hey, especially when that line is out there, you got to pay attention. And we got a man. Better job on the defensive end, right. All right, Mustangs able to get this up with speed here. Looking to get to his line mate. That was Colton Rogan carrying that one up. All right. Gunnar Endres. Pinching against the wall, able to keep that in. Endres fighting for the puck on that right-hand side. North. Flipping
that's
high, and that's way out of play.
It's one of the unique things here, Sean. You and I, we got to be careful. No net.
Yeah. We got hands.
Oh, I thought Cheyenne, I thought they had some nice offensive opportunities early. Obviously, that last shift, we said, not very strong, really sloppy in their defensive zone. But early on in this game, they have had some opportunities to get pucks to the net. They continue to do those things right off faceoffs. We've seen it. We can see what they do here.
Right. Because you figure, who's going to be the most nervous? Probably goalies, right?
I never was one.
You've got the most important job. It's, yeah. All right. Close quarters down there behind the north net. No one's given much room there. Right off the chest. Able to corral that. That's Trace. Trace Myers. Can't see the numbers. Oh, did not get it out again. All right. North player puts
on the
brakes.
Right in front. There you get.
Yeah, got to communicate. We should almost be able to hear the guys talking to one another, how close we are to this right now. Oh, nice little play there. Mustang's able to get that out and put that in. Going to change.
Oh, we are on the road, but Cheyenne Mustang Media is still pleased to announce that Essentia Health is a premier sponsor of Cheyenne Mustang Media, so Essentia Health is like nowhere else. How's that shoulder of yours? Is your rotator cuff getting better?
No, not at all. Wow.
Well, if it's not, you can go to Cheyenne or you can go to Essentia Health.
I think I'm going to have to get a referral, but right? I don't know.
Well, they're tuning in. They've probably heard us, so I think that's your referral right there.
I'll fight through the pain right now. All right. Mustangs looking to keep it in. Nice job there by Dylan Johnson. Shielding the puck, able to keep it in. Cooper Klaus there on the boards. Two Mustangs, two North players as well. Nice little short pass. Oh, good. No look pass. Shot from well out. That was Max Watson, the hero of the last time these two teams met late in the third period. Colton Rogan, little back pass. Nice weight on that one. Mustangs able to clear this one out. Cooper Klaus coming on this right-hand side. Oh, trying to get that across. Almost a nice stick lift there. Creating an opportunity. Shot from a bad angle. But handled easily by Parker Dosh. Mustangs doing a nice job of cycling this. Oh, just out of the reach there. Could have been a good scoring opportunity. All right, all three guys coming up for North. Number one line.
Oh, what a save by Beater.
Wow, a back door. Didn't overcommit, and oh my goodness, that puck has got to get out. That is the third time there. The number one line, I think, is still out here for North. I can't tell. All right, North cranking up the heat. Oh, puck just went over the stick there. That's Owen Branson on the doorstep. Nice hand eye right there to keep that going up the middle, too. All right. North bringing this right back in, and why wouldn't you? Mustangs have a tough time getting the puck out of their own zone right now. All right, going backdoor again. Read nicely by Mustang defender on that one. All right. It's a shooting gallery right now with 8:38 to go here.
Unfortunately, it's going to be too far back, so we're not going to be able to get that save that Jaden Beater made, but Owen Branson made a pass right to, I believe it was Max Watson, right in front. We do catch the last one the Beater made right there, but Cheyenne's got to do a better job in the defensive zone. That was one of the keys.
Yeah.
Right there, just get running around a little bit too much, and you talked about throwing pucks at the middle of the ice. It seems like North is coming in waves right now.
Yeah, here we go. North wins the draw. Mustangs, Christensen trying to get this up. They do get it up. Right back in. They're going to have to tag up. Christensen and Estebo, defensive unit for the Mustangs right now. Oh, nice little breakup at the line. Good shot there. Got the Iverson. Got the Meyer Fritz. Can't quite tell who we got out here.
Iverson, Meyer, and Lashofsky. Yep, Lashofsky.
Meyer, nice job. Nice turnaround. Way to put the brakes on the high slot. And both teams are not afraid to put pucks on net right now. And hey, why not?
Yeah, we've seen Iverson, as we see right here. He's going to take a shot from the wall right there and throw it on net. We've seen Madden Weber throw a shot from down there. Both of them have elicited a rebound. Unfortunately, yep. That time, no one's there. But yeah, not a bad strategy right now.
Because if memory serves me correct, the Mustangs have not held the lead against North this year.
Oh, you're jogging the memory bank there. A little far back shot.
One-nothing loss, and then we were down two.
The one-nothing loss was nothing-nothing after two periods of play. And the guy with the puck right now, Charlie Colbrand, that just stepped offside, he was the one that broke that scoreless tie and got the game-winning goal. And you remember anything about that goal, Sean?
Yeah, we were shorthanded.
Yes.
No, well, we were on the power play. Right, yes, they were shorthanded. Yeah, that was a
two-on-one play and just put it right over.
That
was Beater net that game. Yeah, put it right over his glove.
And then once in the North game, and were we down two late?
That was West Fargo.
That was the Christensen highlight. All right. 7:17 to go in this first period. All right. North looking to head men this red nicely on the play. That was Madden Weber stepping up. All right. North going to try this again, going cross ice. Lost the handle. That was Sam Frittle, couldn't handle it. Colton Rogan trying to find some space there. Mustangs able to keep this in, though. Little touch pass at the center of the ice. Not a lot of room. It's like a hot biscuit right now. Everyone's kind of fumbling it a bit. And there's an opportunity again. A stick at the line. Oh, a little spin move. And they can smell blood. When that turnover, they go from defense to offense in a heartbeat. Yeah, that is something the Mustangs have got to pay attention to.
Yeah, Norris got the last change in this, and a little bit of a mismatch of lines, or that's their top line out against, I don't know if you want to classify it as Cheyenne's third or fourth, but yeah, a little mismatch of lines there.
Nice job of taking the body in the slot there. Oh, here we go. Trace Meyer looking to create something here. Shot, that was dangerous. Going on far side there. And it wasn't handled cleanly by Mr. Parker Dosh in the play, so.
It's twice on his glove now, Sean, and he's fumbled it. Right. Actually, the first one he missed from the neutral zone. That one, trouble.
All right, here comes North. Mustangs out with guys back, though. Oh, look a little offside.
I thought the same as well.
Hello. But the fact that we have an awesome vantage point right now.
You can see it right here on our replay monitor.
We're qualified to say that.
Wow. Yep. You got the bad angle right at the last minute. But nonetheless, we appreciate our officials tonight offering their services selected by the EDC for the postseason.
Right. Congrats, gentlemen. All right, got 5:37.
Got a good crew here tonight.
Remaining in this scoreless first period. North trying to find a lane there. Did get a favorable bounce back to the point. Off a stick or a body.
And offside hazard there. He goes out to the point to block that shot. Little things like that, Sean. Little things, they're going to amount to hopefully victories down the road.
Right. All right, here we go. Draw to the right of Beater. Trace Meyer, I think, taking on his strong side. North, though, with possession, looking to gain something going behind the Mustang goal. Mustang player losing his balance. Colton Rogan, they gained it. All right, shot back to the point. Shot blocked by Colton Rogan. Nice job there blocking that. North is not afraid to utilize their D and then create some chaos in front of Beater. All right, Mustang's gonna put that in. Hassler gonna try and create something there with the speed. Oh, big hit behind, but they're gonna call the interference. I'm not sure in that one.
Thought he was a little delayed in putting his arm up there. I thought Pitts was gonna get away with that hit right there. Nonetheless, they're gonna go with a rough. So Pitts being aggressive down in the neutral zone. I did see the player that went off, but yeah, his helmet did come off.
Yeah, and I don't know if that was a case of big on small and the noise, there was no arm up initially. I think the question was, where was the puck on that? And if it took him a second to determine that.
Well, if that was the case,
but then it would have been interference. You're right.
Interference.
Here we go.
Force a piece either way, though. It's 2 minutes, right?
All right, Cooper Klaus. Looking to create something shorthanded. Puck just hopped over his stick as he was attempting to make a move here with 4:30 to go. First man advantage of the evening. It's going to North. All right. Mr. Ray Wallen setting up shop here on the going cross ice. Nice pass. Going back to the point, looking for a shooting lane. Looking for something up in front. Here comes a shot. He scores. I think that's Owen Branson.
Sean, we've seen that movie before, and it's been the same ending almost every time there. I mean, we've seen that they do a nice job of North of using the whole zone. Wallen gets it over to Owen Branson. This year, that's going to be his 28th assist for Branson. That's going to be his 20th goal.
On the strong side, we had three guys, and then that pass goes to the weak side, and we were just too late getting there. All right. 4 minutes remaining. North draws first blood.
That didn't take North very long either.
Man advantage.
Just a little over 30 seconds, 39 seconds or so.
Here they come again. Number one line has just scored. And that's off of North's stick, so that is not going to be icing. Mustang's going to be the first one. That's Lashowski on it. That's Rogan pinching in there. Nice job able to keep that in. Mustangs with possession. Not a lot of room down there. All right, Rogan looking for a lane. Over. Oh, Weber. Nice low shot. Looking for a deflection. Did not find one, though. Here comes North. goal scorer, Owen Branson, putting that puck in low. Off the net. Trace Meyer playing down low. We get this out. Oh, almost a favorable bounce. Trace Meyer, closest recipient to that one for the Mustangs. Nice little chip up ahead. Oh, shot.
Take the. That's in the back of the net there. Thought they could have taken the puck there from seeing our replay. It's Kahlbrenner that's going to get it at the blue line right there. I thought they had the opportunity to go for the puck. They both go for the hit.
Oh, kind of the stick, but
and stepping right in. Caleb Brigham.
High slot, yes.
Cheyenne coaching staff, they got some questions right here. So Coach Wally and both Coach Benson are kind of standing up with their arms outstretched.
I don't know if they're
referees
that
look like
that
yeah, Coach Benson's got his hand up. I believe that they think that the puck came out of the back of the net. You did hear the ping from a post. Nonetheless, it's going to be Caleb Brigham. It's going to put North up 2-0.
And as tough as goals are, or have been this year, for the Mustangs, they have dug themselves a hole early on here. 2:40 remaining in this first period. Next goal is going to be crucial. All right, Mustangs having a difficult time getting this puck up the ice. North are blocking lanes. Here we go, shot blocked. Mustangs able to get this out. Cooper Klaus looking for support here. Oh, nice pass. Shot coming from Benson. Cannot get it through. Blocked by
Bryce Dietz.
North defender, Bryce Dietz. All right, Mustangs. Oh, making a change here. We got two bodies. Johnson able to get that. Drop pass to Klaus in that one. His place is alive
now. I
was
just going to say, it's heating up in here, Sean.
Yes.
Which it should. I mean, high school athletes and you get into the playoffs, you deserve to have an environment like this to play in. And
there is not a lot of room on the glass, but hey, if you're young and you're not looking to do, I don't care, you could be young, old, I'm not going to discriminate, that's my fault. Get here to the Coliseum right now, because it is electric. 2 minutes exactly remaining in this first period. North with a 2-0 lead.
And North has given their crowd a lot to cheer about so far in this first period. I thought Cheyenne had a decent start to the period, and then defensive zone got a little sloppy, and then see, take the penalty, and then North capitalizes on the power play, and then I don't know the exact time on the clock, Sean, but it couldn't have been more than a minute later, a minute and a half later, it seems like.
Yeah, I'm sure Beater's going to want that one back. It looked like it went 5-hole. And yeah, I think a little bit deflection off the stick. But yeah, it looked like the two Mustangs that were close. Just kind of a fraction of a second too late where that shot came in. You know, one should have taken the player earlier, I thought. But hey. All right, nice job. Mustangs keeping this in. 1:30. Oh, shot from the. Oh, slot. Good opportunity there.
No, you don't score on it, but what a nice offensive zone play here. You got Weber's just going to, instead of firing it off, makes a smart play, gets it to the shots. What a nice pass to Iverson right there. Gets a nice shot. You want to be able to answer from goals.
Yeah.
You want your next couple of shifts to be strong, and good offensive opportunity right there for Cheyenne.
Right in Mr. Parker Dosh's belly, though, right in the breadbasket.
We're not going to. It's the one demerit on the report card.
You're not going to be scoring from there to high school goalie. All right, North looking to clear the zone here. Turn around. It's Gavin Connor. Puck's going to go under the North bench.
Hazler there tips it up, goes into the Fargo North bench.
Well, during intermission, I'm going to give you a little leeway into our tonight's little special treat dealing with something from the North.
Very excited.
All right. Oh, Mustangs, look at back door there, trying to fight through that. Oh, just dribbled through the crease. All right, 1 minute, you can hear that, 1 minute to go in this period. Oh, we're gonna, looks like, I don't know if it was a knee, what they're gonna call interference. Mr.
Kalbrenner's
going to go. Kalbrenner's going to go.
Hit was on Pitts.
Yeah. A lot of chirping going on in the stands. Fans are getting involved in this. All right. 51.7 seconds to cut the deficit in half. This is big, big opportunity.
Yeah, and Cheyenne, obviously they gave up the one. You want to be able to pop one in here. It'd be nice for confidence-wise going into the period break.
Estebo and good vibes. Christensen, I can see in the back end up front.
Meyer, Iverson, and Lashofsky.
There we go. North, though, able to get stick on it, able to get it all the way down. 40 seconds remaining. Mustangs looking to make a smart play, and they do a nice job by Trace Meyer handling that one. Oh, nice little toe drag. Let's go. Oh, just that little hesitation move. I love it. Went to the back end. Oh, puck is wide. Oh, in the crease. Parker Dosh having trouble.
That's three times tonight with his glove.
With the glove.
A little trouble.
Coming out. Created a great scoring opportunity there. Just the puck could not sit down for. Oh, nice little move. Oh, just wide. Mustangs are coming close right now. Going back door. Oh, could not. Nice behind the back pass on that one.
Cheyenne is going to come back in the second period, Sean. They're going to come back with a minute and nine left on the power play. You know my feelings and my thoughts about starting the period on the power play. But it might be something that's going to get Cheyenne jumpstart a little bit, or at least you hope so,
right,
from the Cheyenne perspective.
Right.
At the end of the first here, you saw the wheels come off a little bit with that penalty being taken, and then North getting the power play goal and then responding right after.
You know, we kind of weathered that storm, and it was like, you know, sloppy passes, but it was like, all right, we're okay. And then, if we watch it tonight, we'll see if that, how dangerous a play that was for the first power play for North in that one. Coach Benson still talking, I see, to the ref on that one, so I'm not exactly sure.
Yeah, I believe that they feel like the puck went off the post and came out and that it never fully entered into the net.
Gotcha.
Regardless, as we said, though, that is, they're not going to take it off the board now, but that is going to be Caleb Brigman that's going to get that goal. Couple scores to report, Sean. Both after the first period of play up in Grand Forks. I don't know, they must be in a different time zone than us. They were done earlier than we were.
Up north, I got it.
Anyway, 2-0 Red River after one. They were playing Devil's Lake.
Yep.
And then after the first period of play, Grand Forks Central has a 3-0 lead on Fargo Davies.
Oh.
I'd have to look back, but I think Central's kind of just been getting a little bit better, a little bit better, a little bit better kind of throughout the year. You know, Cheyenne did get them earlier in the season at the Sports Arena, and then 3-2 game, and then Cheyenne went up to Grand Forks to play him at Purper and lost 6-0. So officially, for our score book here, statistics, Parker Dosh was perfect in the first period, 14 for 14. Jaden Beater, 10 saves on 12 shots on goal. First goal scorer was Owen Branson. That was on the power play. Owen Branson assisted by Ray Wallen and Liam Olson. And then Caleb Brigman from Samuel Friddle. Penalties, you had Pitts, went for roughing, and then Kalbrenner with just 51 seconds left for Neen. So as we said, Cheyenne is going to start the second on the power play. We don't have shots on goal on our broadcast here, but they put them up after the first period of play, so 14-12. So it seemed like, Sean, when North got in the zone, they put so much pressure on both Cheyenne forwards and defensemen that they were just turning the puck over, and I feel like that's a little uncharacteristic. I don't know if I've seen them play that sloppy in their defensive zone.
Right.
Fumbling pucks, as you said, trying to funnel them up the middle of the ice. Obviously not the place you want to have the puck in your defensive zone. You want to go more north-south instead of
east-west. And I don't know if I heard pucks off a glass. And I know that might give you possession, I'm just looking at the angle, but, if you go high enough off that glass, it's getting out. We struggled for about a five-minute span there in that first period.
So Cheyenne's going to have their work cut out for him here in the second period, but hopefully that they can get started on the power play. I thought Jaden Beater was very strong in that first period. I know you look at the scoreboard, 2-0 North.
Right.
But there was a few times early on that he had to save the bacon for the Mustangs. He was left to hang out to dry, and he showed up and he came to play, which is usually the case with Jaden and both Brock Berm as well. They've both been very strong this season.
Yeah.
All right, so with that, we will take a short break, and then we'll rejoin you for the second period.
When our path takes an unexpected turn, we keep moving forward. When life sends us a message, we listen. When you're determined to beat the odds, we help you plan for what's next. This is commitment, resourcefulness, determination. These are remarkable people doing remarkable things together.
Hi, I'm Nick, and I work at Marvin. So my team implements technology in manufacturing, so I quickly became really impressed with manufacturing as a setting for engineering. For an engineer, it's kind of a playground. Here at Marvin, specifically in the signature group like we are in Grafton, it is high volume, high option, meaning you have to make a lot of product, but it's always different. I never expected finding a great job like this kind of out here in a small town. Come work at Marvin. It's a great place to work.
Hi, I'm TJ Yoshi here at Marvin Headquarters in Waro, Minnesota. Let's check it out.
Waro is a small town way of life, right on Lake of the Woods. Some of the best fishing in the world.
I think what makes us so unique here is within 15 minutes of me leaving work, I can be out on the lake, I can be on the golf course, I can be on the bike path, I can be out in the Beltrami Island State Forest.
Just a fantastic way to grow up and to live life.
Hi, I'm Micah and I work at Marvin. I've been in the military for 8 years. I was a preventive medicine technician in the U.S. Navy, and so that translated over to working at Marvin and how can safety help make Marvin a better company. The culture working at Marvin is probably the best one I've worked with other than being in the military. Working together and caring about each other, you feel like you're part of the family at Marvin. Come work with me at Marvin, it's a great place to work.
Hi, I'm Christian, and I work at Marvin. My military background is the basis of who I am. I was looking for something to help me be the Marine who wasn't a Marine anymore. Belonging to Marvin feels like I'm part of something. I know that being with Marvin means I'm making a difference in every homeowner's life because the windows, skylights, and doors that I'm helping to build. Come work with me at Marvin. I think you'll enjoy it.
There is no off-season for greatness. You do what it takes to stay in the game. And so do we. Our commitment is to keep you moving forward. Essentia Health Orthopedics and Sports Medicine. Like nowhere else.
I think what makes Touchmark special is how you feel when you walk into Touchmark at Harwood Groves. We often hear that it's like a North Dakota hug.
I think it's the people that make Touchmark special.
One of the things that makes Touchmark is the caliber of the team members here.
You could ask them for anything and they'll say, "We'll take care of it."
Every day that we walk in these doors, we really take time to listen to each other, to listen to our residents, and to be there and to be a friend.
Hi, I'm TJ Oshie here at Marvin headquarters in Warro, Minnesota.
The Lake Town way of life is appealing to so many people.
We've got a thriving school system, coffee shops, breweries, restaurants, and hockey is the hub of our community. We're probably the last place left in Minnesota where hockey's actually free.
The way Marvin supports the town supports Marvin is awesome.
There's opportunities for you. Work hard, self-educate. The sky's the limit here at Marvin.
I chose a career in manufacturing because I wanted to come into work and not be at a desk all day. So with my role, I get to be out on the floor and working with other people and then come back to my desk and try and solve some of the problems that they're facing.
People look at a manufacturing plant, they mostly just see line work, but there's a lot more going on behind the scenes that allows you to explore different kinds of network interfaces or problem-solving situations. There's machines and computers and human interface devices that are constantly being innovated into a manufacturing workplace.
The best days at work are when you get to solve the problem or when you finally get that aha moment and you know, okay, like this is gonna be it. Like this is what we've been thinking about. This is what we've been hoping for.
Knowing that I'm but a part of building something very unique and important, that just makes me very proud.
Welcome back to the John E. Carlson Coliseum, where after one period of play, the Fargo North Spartans have potted themselves a two-goal lead over the Cheyenne Mustangs in this first-round matchup of the EDC tournament. We talked about after one period of play, 2-0 Red River, 3-0 Grand Forks Central over Davies at the end of one, and then over at Farmers Union at the end of the first period, West Fargo and Fargo South Shanley are deadlocked at one. So, competitive game, just like we said. We figured this would be competitive. Hopefully Cheyenne can find a little bit of offensive life here in the second.
Yeah. All right, speaking of offense, my friend, we are going to go with the top 10 North Dakotan-born NHL players in history. And you get a pictorial. At number 10.
Luke Johnson from
Mr.
Grand
Luke
Central.
Johnson.
Yes.
Yep. Clocking in at a 2 points in his career.
I don't know. He's made a nice career in the AHL for himself.
Yes. Played number nine.
Number nine. David Tanneby.
That is Mr. Barry Tallickson.
What?
Yep.
Know where he was born, right?
No.
Grafton.
Shut the front door.
Grandparents lived there. He played for the Gophers. God, how didn't I get that?
Oh, my goodness.
Two-time national champion at Minnesota.
And number eight with the sweet flow. He's probably above that now, but.
I think the only one on that list that has played against the Cheyenne Mustangs, and that's Tyler Clevin.
There
and,
he is.
Boy, when he played against him, he was only a sophomore, but he played like he was a 22-year-old man out there.
6'4". Put on some muscle since then. Yeah. All right, we got to talk power play here. All right, Mustangs looking to create something here. We got Christensen at the point waiting for something, but interrupted
nice,
by North.
Nice
40
play
seconds.
By Ray Wall in there.
Does it all, doesn't he? All right, Mustangs looking to create something. Got some fresh ice. Nice little drop pass at the line. Blockered away by Parker Dosh. Mustangs looking to get on this. North first in on it, though. Good stick by Trace Meyer, but not able to hold it in. Going to have time for maybe one more rush. 10 seconds here. Try and cut this deficit in half. Oh, nearly had his pocket picked. That was Charlie Estebo. All right, Mustangs got off the skate. No, not able to. Oh, out of the box. Nearly hit him. All right. Cy Hassler using his good speed. No one in front, though. No one home. All right, Mustangs. Looking like he got hurt on the play there. Couldn't see what was going on. It was Cooper Klaus. I don't know if he's quite 100%, but looked like to be favoring something on that hit. All right, Mustangs, nice job of breaking that one up. Just can't get anything going. Pucks are just a little behind or a little too far forward. Puck was tipped and negates the icing. Gonna turn it around here. Hard off the boards. A little soft, a little too hard on that one. Benson, nice job of being the first one on the puck, trying to center it. Off a North defender, though. North, gonna head down this puck. It's that number one unit out there. Owen Branson to the right. Oh, back door. Beater just able to get enough of the pad on that one to keep that puck out. All right. Oh, again. Shot. Looking to find someone back door. Backpedaling. Going to give and go. No, looking for Wallen on that one. Oh, just off the stick of Gavin Connor. We had a Mustang defender going to be home free on that one. All right, shot from Beater. Well out. Nice job.
That's that.
Corral that puck.
What'd you call him? The B-dubs line earlier with Branson?
B-dub.
B-dub Wallen.
Yeah.
One of the things that's nice about watching them is they never really throw the puck away. They always wait, and they try to make a play, and they're patient, and obviously they're very offensively skilled, and they know where each other are at, but when you're playing in the diesel, that can be awfully frustrating because you're doing a lot of running around.
Kind of taking a page out of the Red River book because they've done that for decades. Always making sure to make the smart play. All right, Mustangs, nice stretch pass there. Not able to handle it, though. Had it on a stick for a second. Off. All right. Good stick. Prevent Max Watson from getting a shot off. North right in on it though. We're going to go behind the back of the slot. Giveaway by the Mustangs though. All right. Good job of keeping the puck at least to the periphery if they're not able to get it out. But you just feel that there's just a hair away from springing someone in the offensive zone. No, it's nerve-wracking at this point. Because the puck is not on our stick very long. It's in terms of possession. Oh, backdoor.
Is that? I mean, right there, we talked about the plays that they make. How pretty of a goal. I mean, if you like watching offensive players play hockey, these three guys right here, they're fun to watch.
Yeah.
I mean, what else can you say? Wallen and Branson, they make it look pretty easy, too. I mean, you have two passes right there. Max Watson, is the goal scorer right there. And And it just seems like this period, Cheyenne, pucks are off sticks, they're in skates, they're not completing passes. And you said it, Sean, it just felt like the next one was going to be the one that it was. And that was a very pretty goal by Fargo North right there. And so Cheyenne talked about that mountain at the end of the first.
And it just got even bigger. Just the case. It's like, I'm not sure who I'm supposed to cover. And then Watson had so much room on that. All right. Mustangs got to get this next one before they turn this into a rout. So 3-0, 12:40 remaining in this second period. All right, North with looking to get this up. They're going. That was Marcus Ellingson going way high on that one, trying to sauce that one. Oh, puck. Oh, close all the lanes, blocked. He felt that one. But a nice play by Maddox Watson. Oh, good keeping. No, they're going to say no.
Sean, you and I attended the game earlier this year between these two teams at the Coliseum, and one of the things that we both remarked during that game is how many shots Fargo North blocked, and tonight they're playing absolutely no different. We saw Maddox Watson on that shift. They had another one, you know, and they've done it throughout the game. And the other thing you see here is here's that line again. So, I mean, they're getting them out there every opportunity they can.
Yeah.
Look at Branson's got a goal and an assist. Watson's got a goal. You got Wallen's got two assists. So.
All right, here we go.
Look out here.
Going back door again. Yeah, the puck. Yeah, the puck just seems to find them. And, I mean, they're creating that. I mean, the space and I mean, just the familiarity with one another. It's just, yeah, it's nice to watch. It's nerve-wracking for us.
Yes.
All right, 11:40 remaining. All right. And once again on the good coverage on that play. Able to thwart that backdoor opportunity for North. Oh, nice drop pass at the line. But there they are on the puck right again. Two defenders back for Cheyenne, luckily. That was Watson, had it cocked and loaded, I believe, or it could have been Wallen.
Looks like a little shuffling of lines here, Sean. You got Lashofsky with Meyer and Klaus out there.
Puck, here we go. Klaus, oh, blocked again. Oh, high. Off the dasher. North scrambling a bit. They were down a stick, and then they blew a tire at the line. Able to get this out, though. They're making a change. There's no support there for Mr. Dietz. He's all by himself there up. Oh, Cooper Klaus had line mate going to the net. Puck was just too far. Oh, nice little no-look pass.
Two blocks
shot.
Again there,
Yeah. Pucks just aren't getting there clean. All right, Mustang's going to have to clear the zone here. Chip this one in. Parker Dosh play that one cleanly. Oh, a little fumble right there in front of the net, but no one around. Oh, yeah. Jack Amundsen lost the handle on that one. No. Little shot to the back of the head. Nothing more going to materialize. Yeah, tough sledding for the Mustangs right now. North is locking it down pretty tight. And Benson takes a hit. Makes the play, though, off the Mustang stick. Estebo, Mason Christensen taking a hit. Make the play, though.
You have to see how hard he had to work just to get to the red line, get it deep, and take that hit right there. I mean, there's not a whole lot of free space on the ice right now.
All right, give and go at center ice here. North, well out. Handled easily by Beater on that one.
Hard shot there by Kahlbrenner. Yeah, just playing the neutral zone. Seems like every time the North gets the puck on their stick and they pick their head up and look, that one of their line mates is joining the rush right there. And we see a puck went cross ice there to Kahlbrenner. Nice shot on Beater.
Winning draws, creating opportunities. Yeah, it has been all North in this second period, continuing where they left off in the first. But to Cheyenne's credit, you know, fairly even for the most part. Not here in the second. Time of possession tilted.
Don't
want to
know what it is.
The North. Yeah. All right, Mustangs looking to create something, get out of their own zone. Ah, there's just puck on stick, off stick, but not. There comes North. Nice block there. Nice shot. Well out, but a lot of traffic though. So everything that's been funneled towards the net looks dangerous for North. All right, North first on the puck though. Nice job here. Able to get this out, but you know, all we're doing is relieving pressure. We're not creating any offensive opportunities here.
Yeah, that's difficult in the second period too, because you got the long change.
Yes.
And so you got guys changing and they're trying to, you know, turn and go up ice, so it's not always the best recipe.
Yeah. No.
Nice opportunity.
Here we go,
here.
2-on-1. Oh, lays down. Couldn't get that puck across like he wanted to, but still got a shot on net. Probably our best scoring opportunity of the period with 8 minutes to go here. Here comes the number one line. Drop pass. Wow. Look at how much time Max Watson had on that one. As we kept on collapsing, and you know, on that goal, there was no one within 10 feet of him.
No, that, you're absolutely right there. And Beaters had to make some big saves tonight for the Mustangs. And, you know, as you said, I mean, time, and he had a ton of time, and he had a ton of space.
Yep. And the number one line has what? Right? They're in on all three goals?
Yep. Well, no, Brigham had the second one.
Oh, that's right. Yep. Yeah. That's right.
But all it seems like they've been out there almost every other shift.
See, look at that.
Your Coach Klein, I keep him out there as much as much as I can.
And it's just puck battles and not winning. Puck's going to, manage to get it out. But, I mean, we're just backpedaling here. All right, 7:30 remaining. 3-0 North.
You kind of look at North's forecheck right here. Kind of passive a little bit, kind of waiting for, almost like Cheyenne, while they're going for a change too. That plays into it, but it's kind of baiting Cheyenne in a little bit. Seems
nice
play.
Pass in the middle. Get a backdoor opportunity there, but off a stick.
So it is going to be Klaus. It is going to be out there with now Meyer and Lashofsky. So obviously some
juggling of lines.
Juggling after that first period,
right.
Trying to get the offense going a little bit, create a spark. Coach Benson and his coaching staff have juggled up their forward units a little bit here in the second period.
All right. See what we can do here. Draw one cleanly by North. Nice job. Colton Rogan able to keep that in. Trace Meyer going to play that puck down below the goal. North, we're going to get this out. Off a skate. Nice little move. Coming up with speed here. Drop pass at the line. Handled easily by Beater. No traffic in front.
Yeah, that shot from Kahlbrenner comes out there. We see Brigham. He's going to carry it up through the neutral zone. As he enters over the blue, he just drops it for Kahlbrenner. But that shot's from well above the top of the circles. No one in front of Beater. Able to easily to snake that.
Oh, volume is increasing in here. It's like
Luke Bryan concert.
Holy
cow. Coming through the speakers here.
All right, Mustangs win a draw. Looking to get this out. Nice play by Madden Weber. Saw that there was a little space. Took it in front of his goal. All right. Nice block there by the Mustangs. But, the neutral zone is tough sledding for the Mustangs. And that's putting it mildly. All right, here they come again. Mustangs able to get that out. They're going to have to clear the zone, not realizing what's happening. And they're going to have to blow that one down.
Was that Liam Olsen got caught deep in the offensive zone there. His adrenaline got pumping a little too much there and didn't hear the ref calling for the offside, so that faceoff's going to come all the way down here now to North's defensive zone.
All right, you may not know this one's a little before your time. Number 8 from Crystal, North Dakota.
That's Cliff Fido-Perper.
That is not a good guess, though. That is Mr. Fern Headley. Head of his time. Good head of hair.
Oh,
too,
right
by
off
way.
The poster.
Oh,
from
my
Meyer.
Goodness. Oh, they thought it
and
was
now
in.
Now they're saying that one was in. So.
Oh. Mustang faithful. Oh, nice move by Klaus, but right
Man,
in the middle.
Josh has struggled with that glove tonight.
Yes. Yeah, I guess maybe. Oh, nice. Little pickup by Charlie Espo. We're going the other way here. Mustangs.
Uh-oh,
here feeling it right now. We got a 2-on-1, though. Estebo coming back, though, takes the stick. Nice job thwarting that one. Oh, but back doors open a bit. Mustangs, can they get this out? No, they cannot. Nice play at the line. Head up. Oh, do not overskate it. Michalski just looking to get this out. Cooper Klaus did not get it.
Yeah, that shot by Meyer there. We're going to have to go back, Sean, and watch it. From traffic in front of the net.
Yeah.
Looked like it went off of the post. There was a contingent. Obviously, I saw one of the Cheyenne assistant coaches was pointing with his hand as if indicating that thought the puck went in the net. So
yeah, some of the faithful were standing saying that was
right,
in.
We'll have to go back and see on that. But all indications are off the post.
All
as
right,
now.
5 and change remaining. 3-0 Spartans. Mustangs mounting a little bit of a charge here. Just need to, oh, cannot handle that cleanly. Oh my goodness,
oh boy,
was he flying in. Was that Wallen on that one?
Kalbrenner.
Or is that Kalbrenner? Wow, that train had a destination. Luckily, able to sidestep that. All right, that's just a tough pass. 2 feet off the ice in the middle. All right, Mustangs, oh, nice play, nice little drag. Nice pinch right here coming up. Shot does not get through. Back to the point. Oh, just missed on that one. Madden Weber with a good look. High slot, cannot get it through the three North defenders that were taking their defensive responsibilities very seriously. All right, Cooper Klaus out there again. Oh, dangerous. Part shot, part backhand. That was that top corner labeled. All right. North looking to center this one. That is Watson. Going to take a look around. Oh, puck beater just kind of exposed there, but nice job of not giving up on the man. Just kind of ran out of real estate and lost
all
his
alone
footing.
In front was
yes.
Ray Wallen.
Yeah.
Dangerous forward. We said
yeah.
He's got 2 points tonight. Branson found him all alone in front, but as you said, was never able to one get the puck kind of squarely on his stick or firmly on his stick there and make a play. Don't love that he was standing all alone in front, though. A nice play off the faceoff there.
Oh, get that away from the goal. There we go. Off the glass, out. And then chase. But headman so efficiently there by North. Very few errant passes, and that's not something we're seeing from the Mustangs here. So good job of keeping them. Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's all right. I mean, as long as it's out of the zone, I mean, yeah, let's get fresh troops.
Yeah, sometimes an ace doesn't have to be the worst play in the world.
Right, right.
Unfortunately, a lot of this period seems like it's been played down in that end. A lot
yes.
of the pressure has, so we'll see. You're nearing the end of the period here, 3:13 left, and trying to really kind of hang on the next 3:13, get to locker room, get a little bit of a break, get a little bit of a breather, and then obviously you're not just going to play the next 3:13 out. You want to put pressure on, but try to alleviate the pressure when you can.
Now we got Meyer, Klaus, yeah. Juggling lines, trying to get something before this period ends. Cut into this North lead. Oh, good weight on that one. Shot. Oh, just blocked. Shot from the point. High in the air. Like a jump ball. Mustangs. Oh, just had a linesman in the way. Couldn't quite. Oh, shot. Good block there. Mason Christensen, nice job. What thwarted what could have been a point-blank opportunity in the slot by that number one line, which has been so dangerous tonight. Oh, my goodness. Yeah, Parker Dosh. Just, if that had been in the middle of the net, that would have been in the net. Oh, there's a nice glove hand. Save Parker Dosh, handled that one cleanly.
Kind of opened up a little bit there for a minute.
Yeah.
So flirt around the north net for Cheyenne, and then Branson comes around, as you mentioned, I think maybe a little bit aided by the linesman as he was trying to
yes,
be Estebo
yeah.
into the zone there.
Oh, right.
Or not aided, impeded yeah. rather, excuse
well,
me.
Depends if you're who you're cheering
yeah,
for.
Yeah, yeah.
All right. Two Mustangs down below the goal trying to get, oh, good bounce. Shot from the point. Steered aside by Dosh. No one in front, though. Mustang, the reverse hit there. Trying to keep it in. Is that Erickson? All right, Fritz. Oh, nice pass to the point. Wrist shot high, well wide. Did not get all of that one. All right, 1:42 remaining in the second period. North able to dig this out. Big pinch at the line, though. That was Colton Rogan. Good job. North, though. Oh, one of the few passes not to the intended target in North in this period. Kind of hopped over the stick and into the neutral zone. Oh, good hit in neutral zone. Shot off a stick into the netting behind Mr. Jaden Beater.
Looks like Jaden Rogan got dinged up on that last shift there. You saw him skate off. Colton Rogan, excuse me, skated off very slowly. Looks like he's on the bench holding that shoulder there. He was injured for a few games, so keep an eye on that. Hopefully he remains healthy. Cheyenne, obviously playing without the services of Jackson Glinke as well tonight. So,
oh, boy. My goodness. Wow. That puck hopped right. Did that pop right over the stick, right in the slot? The only good news of that,
yeah, Brigham just
that there wasn't enough move, yeah. enough room to make a move.
He put that right into the net.
Oh,
fortunately for Cheyenne,
goodness.
It was the white netting up top, not the white netting right
off,
behind Jane Beater.
Off a Mustang skate into the paint. Oh, that would have been a backbreaker with a minute
with
to
a minute,
go.
Yep,
oh my
it,
goodness.
Buddy.
Yeah, oh, nice little play here. Couldn't quite tell who that is. Estebo. No, Lischowski.
No, Lischowski. Estebo's out there, though.
There we go, yeah. All right. There he is. Nice move. Oh, nice shot on net by Lischowski. Just going to say his name over and over. The puck seems to be following him this shift. All right, North. Oh, good stick there by Charlie Estebo. 15 seconds remaining. Mustangs got, oh,
got
home
him.
Run pass. Got it. Oh, just over the stick. No, he must have touched it. They are not calling icing. So that was Cooper Klaus able to.
Yeah, they'll probably just rake this out here.
Yeah, right. Yeah. Well, it finished better than it started, my friend. And that was with the power play. So,
yeah, Cheyenne did have a minute and nine power play time to start the period. Fortunately, they weren't able to do much of that. In the second, we did see Watson got on the board for the Spartans. And, yeah, just kind of a period, I don't know how to describe it, all out of sorts. It seemed like pucks were bouncing over sticks. There wasn't a whole lot of cohesion, it seemed like, in the D zone. I mean, you made a couple comments, a couple mentions on how it was just – it would seem like it was just to relieve pressure for a little bit longer,
yeah.
a little bit longer. It seemed like there wasn't a whole lot of connectivity coming out of the zone.
And
unfortunately, they weren't able to mount much offensive pressure in that second
right,
period.
They were juggling lines. Last 5 minutes, though, better.
Yeah, they had a couple opportunities. You talked about that opportunity that Trace Meyer had. You know, it's maybe the best one they've had all game so far up to this
right,
point.
Right, right. I'm going to say we're outshot by 8 in that period.
Well. Shots are 24-24. We had 12 after the first. They had 14.
Wow.
So,
that.
You know, there's some times that they have some offensive flurries. Now you're looking at a third period where you got to score four to win, and you're going to have to start taking some chances offensively. Now, whether that's activating your D a little bit more than usual, or maybe it's, you know, putting a guy up into the neutral zone and trying to stretch the ice a little bit, but it's going to be tough. I'd say one thing, if I were Cheyenne and their forwards, anytime the D get the puck and a shot's going to the net, I think one thing that, you know, Dosh has been sterling tonight so far. He hasn't allowed a goal, but I think he'd like some shots back in terms of rebound control. He's given up quite a few rebounds, especially on the glove hand side. So if you can get around the net and you can create a little bit of pressure, and maybe get some of those Fargo North defensemen running around a little bit and create an offensive zone opportunity, because they're gonna have to find a way to put pucks in the back of the net, and they got to get four of them. They don't have a whole lot of time.
Right. We're not deviating from priority number one either. Is that if we're gonna take some chances, you better make darn sure who is on the ice for North. You better take a double take, because any errant pass, and you know they're going to be licking their chops, especially if we're trying to stretch the ice. It's like, oh man, boom. And I mean, all of a sudden, you got to be careful.
Yeah, and you know what? They're out there all the time, though. So how do you?
Yeah, I know.
How do you combat? I mean, that's a difficult thing.
Yes.
When a team has a dynamic line like that, it's tough to match up against them, and they make life difficult on your first, second, third line. That's one of the difficult things. And Cheyenne tonight, you haven't really had the answer for those three that they've wanted. Obviously, Branson has the power play goal, and Watson in second. But man, if you could, I don't know how many shots that you talked about, time of possession too. And so, in the third period now, I mean, you still got to stay connected as a team. You can't unravel now. You got to find a way. Early on, I'd say in the first 5 minutes, you want to get that first one.
You don't want to. You have to.
Yes, and then
I'm going to say at this juncture right now, the way it's played out, we have to get that first one.
See if you can somehow get it to 3-2, and then you go 6-on-5 if you can, and then at that point, you know, who knows. And so if you're Cheyenne, you know, early on, you got to be dialed in and see if you can pop one here against Dosh.
All right, let's save our energy for the third. Ready?
Them or us?
Let's us.
I agree.
All right. Not them. They're young.
Yeah. All right, so with that, we'll take a short break, and then we'll come back for our final period of play.
Our health. It's what keeps us doing what we love. It keeps our communities strong. So, how are you doing? There's no easier way to take care of yourself than checking in with us, your primary care team at Essentia Health. In person or online, we offer scheduling and appointment options that fit your life. We'll care for you today and keep an eye on things for the future, and if needed, get you back on track. So take some time to connect with us, because it's always good to check in.
Hi, I'm TJ Oshie here at Marvin headquarters in Waro, Minnesota. Let's check it out.
Waro is a small town way of life right on Lake of the Woods. Some of the best fishing in the world.
I think what makes us so unique here is within 15 minutes of me leaving work, I can be out on the lake, I can be on the golf course, I can be on the bike path, I can be out in the Beltrami Island State Forest.
Just a fantastic way to grow up and to live life.
Hi, I'm Micah, and I work at Marvin. I've been in the military for 8 years. I was a preventive medicine technician in the U.S. Navy, and so that translated over to working at Marvin and how can safety help make Marvin a better company. The culture of working at Marvin is probably the best one I've worked with, other than being in the military. Working together and caring about each other, you feel like you're part of the family at Marvin. Come work with me at Marvin. It's a great place to work.
Here, when your future lies ahead, we help set you on the right course. When your whole world is about to change, we help you prepare for your new life. When staying healthy means staying informed, we help you find answers. This is perseverance, understanding, connection. These are remarkable people. doing remarkable things together.
In this place, we face obstacles like nowhere else. The clock, the trail, the hill, the challenge that's always waiting. When that challenge comes, we'll meet it together. Because this, it's your chance to show what you're made of. Tenacity, resilience, and the power to prove that the toughest competition comes from within. This is orthopedics and sports medicine like nowhere else.
I'm Kyle, and I'm a trainer at Marvin. I work on the night shifts because it works with my schedule. When I first started at Marvin, I started in the forklift department. I was there for 3 months, and I saw an opportunity for a new position. I've never been at a company that has made me feel like they actually do care about my career and my career development. I've just had jobs in the past, and I really feel like this is the first time I'm actually in a career. Come join me on the evening shift at Marvin. It's a great team, and you'll have a lot of fun.
Hi, I'm Diana, and I work at Marvin. Working in manufacturing, not a lot of sitting, so it just makes your day go by faster. Belonging to Marvin makes me feel stable. 25 years. My kids were little when I started here in Grafton. Now I have a daughter that works here. She was one of the ones that pushed me to become the lead, pushed me to be the person that I am now. And I just see myself retiring here. If you're looking for an awesome place to work, come join me at Marvin.
What does it take to make fitness part of your lifestyle? It's intention. It's commitment. It's resilience. It's just who you are. You put in the time and effort to stay active. Our expert orthopedic and sports medicine providers also put in the time and effort to invest in new methods and treatments. Whatever you do to stay active, we are here to keep you moving. It's just who we are. Orthopedics and sports medicine like nowhere else.
Here, when our path takes an unexpected turn, we keep moving forward. When life sends us a message, we listen. When you're determined to beat the odds, we help you plan for what's next. This is commitment, resourcefulness, determination. These are remarkable people doing remarkable things together.
I'm Nick, and I work at Marvin. So my team implements technology in manufacturing, so I quickly became really impressed with manufacturing as a setting for engineering. For an engineer, it's kind of a playground. Here at Marvin, specifically in the signature group like we are in Grafton, it is high volume, high option, meaning you have to make a lot of product, but it's always different. I never expected finding a great job like this kind of out here in a small town. Come work at Marvin. It's a great place to work.
Hi, I'm TJ Oshie here at Marvin headquarters in Warro, Minnesota.
The Lake Town way of life is appealing to so many people.
We've got a thriving school system, coffee shops, breweries, restaurants, and hockey is the hub of our community. We're probably the last place left in Minnesota where hockey's actually free.
The way Marvin supports the town supports Marvin is awesome.
There's opportunities for you, work hard, self-educate. The sky's the limit here at Marvin.
Hi, I'm Gabby, and I work at Marvin. When I first started at Marvin, I was a production associate, and I was shocked at how bright the floor was, how clean it was. It can be a very fast-paced environment, but it can also be very fun. I feel great about the growth opportunities at Marvin, especially because I started as a production associate and then worked my way into being an HR coordinator. If you're interested in working in manufacturing or you've never worked in a manufacturing environment before, I would definitely say come try it out. It might surprise you. It can be very fun and rewarding.
when I first started, my training was very extensive. I was able to advance fairly quickly within Marvin, and it's just a matter of telling people that you're interested and really applying yourself. Belonging to Marvin feels like you're part of something, so it's more than just a job. For me, it's a career, and it's been a really exciting journey for me.
All right, fans, welcome back for Sean. What's going to be our final period of hockey, unless this baby goes into overtime. Welcome back to the Coliseum. We're after two periods of play. Fargo North Spartans have built a 3-0 lead as we go into our final 17. A look around the rest of our EDC tournament. Three other games were played tonight.
Yep, let's hear it.
All starting at 7 o'clock. We'll start up in the 1-8 game after two periods of play. It is 4-2 in favor of Grand Forks Red River.
Fairly tight.
Like to see the shots there.
Yeah.
The goaltender for Devil's Lake is a strong goaltender. Sees a lot of pucks throughout the regular season and is a very good goaltender. In the game against Davies and Central, that's our 2-7, 4-1 Grand Forks Central. And then in that 4-5 matchup, after two periods of play, Fargo South Shanley is up on West Fargo 3-1.
All right. Well, the Mustang cheering section let them have it just before we got on the air here to get this team fired up. So no excuses. It's loud in here. Here we go. Right off the hop, Trace Meyer. Oh, good opportunity there. Oh, just over the stick, behind the back pass. Estebo at the hash marks. Meyer looking to create something here. But North is able to break that up and bring it to the neutral zone. Watson, oh, to Mr. Wallen. But from this vantage point, he's already kind of beyond the point of being able to score that one, put it over the net. All right, here come the Mustangs again. Meyer off the glove. And Mr. Parker Dosh. There comes, there they come again, Wallen again. Looking to curl that one in. Cannot, read by the Mustangs. Nice no-look pass coming up this right-hand side. Shot from way out though. Hoping to get a good bounce. Cannot quite corral that one. Can't tell if that was Iverson or not. Nice keep in. Oh, looking to go back door on that one. Oh, nice job. Mustangs digging it out. Madden Weber. Cooper Klaus.
Benson on that one.
Benson. Yep. Yeah. Oh, is it Benson? Nice little feed, but oh, cannot handle it cleanly. That's going to come all the way down. Madden Weber with a little sense of urgency there, getting this puck up. Off the stick, though. Touched in by North. But that was Trace Meyer trying to spring, but even if he had got that puck cleanly, there was two North players right on him. And that's been kind of the story all game. Not much real estate for the Mustangs.
One thing to keep an eye on here, we see Klaus Meyer and Lashofsky, they're right back out there after starting the period. It'll be interesting to see kind of how deep into the forward lineup they go here if they try to keep, you know, that group out there as much as they possibly can. They are the top 3 point scorers for Cheyenne this season. They played a good chunk of it together.
Oh, North. Oh, Beater able to fight that one off. Good little hesitation move in the low slot in that one. Ah, oh, see? Behind the back pass, not to anyone in orange on that one. It was red by North. off the glass, kicked ahead. That was Maddox Watson. I believe he has played some soccer. Looked like a soccer player on that one. All right, North chipping that in. Mustangs off a skate. Decent pass, but not able to be handled cleanly. Shot hammered in. Going cross ice. North gonna change. But here comes the fresh troops, creating difficulty for the Mustangs, like they have all game. Shot from the point, fanned on. But right on to the stick of Max Watson. Brother combination there. Oh. Off a Cheyenne glove on the bench. 13:53. Time is becoming the enemy. I'm going to go out on a limb right now and say that.
Yes, it certainly is, Sean. I don't know what more to add to that than what you just said. We talked about first 5 minutes. Certainly advantageous to Cheyenne to get one, so we'll see what they can do at the next
and go,
2 minutes here. If
they
can.
Pucks in the Mustang zone. They got their number one unit on there, winning the draw cleanly. They wrapped it around almost. That was Max Watson on that one, I believe. Looking for her second of the night. All right, here we go with a little bit of speed. Jack Pitts trying to break through. Cannot. Just coming out with speed time and time again. Nice little hesitation move there. Oh, puck hopped up on the right-hand side of Beater. Madden Weber looking to create things on his own there. Oh, puck goes through the slot. All right. Mr. Wallen looking to create something here. Taking it behind the net. Not handled cleanly by anyone. All right, Mustangs looking to create. 3-on-1, though. And nowhere to go for Mr. Caden Fritz on that opportunity. Brigham. Shot looking for a rebound. Did not find one. Here come the Mustangs. Puck too far in front. Oh, almost got away with one there. Looking for a little toe drag on that one. Lost the handle. Oh, looking to spring Mr. Gunnar Endres. Just out of his reach. Mustangs, though, with possession. One timed in by Landon Erickson on that play. 12 minutes to go here. North with an errant pass. Haven't seen that very often. Able to get it back though. Mustangs looking to do something in the neutral zone. Cannot. Try and hammer it off the glass. Nice little move there. Cooper Klaus, the guy you want with the puck for the Mustangs. Shot.
Oh. Good opportunity by Meyer.
Good low shot on that one. Cooper Klaus, nice job picking the pocket of the North defender. Oh, the linesman got in the way of the defense, trying to keep that puck in. I see the glare he gave him. Then he takes a shot in the belly. Trace Meyer, oh, he's open on the left. That's going to be offside. A little hesitation move on the line, caught everyone off guard on his line. Mr. Estebo on that one. All right. Oh, good hit, neutral zone there. Separating Mr. Liam Olson from the puck. I don't know if we got a stick on that one, and we did not.
Nope.
All right.
Find him.
Just like the Sebastian Ajos of today, number 6 on the all-time North Dakota scoring.
This guy right here?
Right here, number 6.
Oh, Mike Peluso.
Yes,
Mike Peluso?
One of the two Mike Pelusos. One liked to fight, one had a little more talent.
Mike Peluso, the former Bismarck Demons head coach.
Yeah, grand total of 6 points in his NHL career. Number 6 on the list, 6 points. All right. Mustangs with a shot on net from way out. So, I mean, we're not going to score on that. Knife to head. Parker Dosh going to put that off the glass. Allow his teammates to get that one out of the zone, and they do. Colton Rogan taking a look, going to ring this around.
Offside.
All right. All right, Mr. Benson looking to create something nice. Oh, cannot quite, just off a North stick on that one. All right, Mustangs, nice pass. Oh. All right, Cooper Klaus, nice play in the neutral zone. 3 Mustangs trying to get something going here. Chase Meyer trying to headman that to Cooper Klaus, cannot. All right, nice hard shot by Mason Christensen, getting it in deep. Oh, knife to head nicely. Awaiting North forward. Inside outside move there. That was Mr. Wallen on the play. All right. Good speed coming through the neutral zone. Shoved off the puck though. Cooper Klaus going to try this again. We've got 3 Mustangs up here. Shot blocked. Turns into nothing. What was promising for a second there as we had 3.
Yeah, Klaus slid it over to Meyer, and you can see right there.
Yeah.
I believe it's Maddox Watson that just goes down, takes a knee right in front of Meyer, and Meyer puts it, I think, right off the toe of his skate and up into the netting.
I would have dropped that back.
Just kind of
bide some time.
Story of the offense there for
right.
A lot of blocked shots by North,
yeah.
And not able to get a lot of pucks to the net and have really good grade A opportunities.
8:50 remaining in the third period. North still up 3-0. Mustangs have yet to solve Mr. Parker Dosh on the evening. All right. Oh, lost the handle. At the goal line. Oh, deflected. A number one line making it miserable for the Mustangs. Ray Wallen with a nice tip. He's calling for it again. All right, Mustangs first in on it. Mustangs. Oh, Mason Christensen blows the tires. Could be a odd man advantage. Good job. And Jack Pitts coming back on that one.
As Sean, to steal a quote from Yogi Berra, it's getting late early out here.
Yes.
Times is slipping away on the Mustangs right here. You still have plenty of time left.
7:57,
but you'd like to see a little bit more positive offensive momentum built into that.
Well, the number of grade A scoring opportunities I can definitely put on one hand. So we've got some shots. Oh. All right, opportunity number 5 on the greatest North Dakotans in NHL history, points-wise.
Paul Ledoux.
Paul Ledoux.
Grand Forks,
big
Central.
Increase in points, 18 for his career.
Very good defenseman from Grand Forks Central.
Yes, sir.
Kind of a part of that run over Central had. It seemed like where they had, I don't know, 15, 16 guys that went on to play Division I, maybe more than that. I think they have maybe 9 or 10 playing right now.
Still to this day, you think?
Right now?
Oh, that's nice. Oh, my goodness. Dangerous pass.
Well, maybe not right now, but from
yes, okay.
From that run of three-peats, I know they have 9 guys that went to
Division I. 7:20. Oh, puck. Through the slot there, Mustang's not there. No look behind the back pass, does not find the intended target. All right, Norris is gonna change on that one. Friddle's gonna dump that in. Stretch pass, here we go. I think that we've got to. We're down to 7 minutes.
Exactly.
We've gotta create some opportunities. Doesn't matter if you lose 8-0. You know, you've gotta take some chances right out here right now. That number one line was not out. Yeah, there we go. Tough on the forecheck.
create something, get a good bounce. Oh. Oh, puck. Oh, oh, off the post. There it is, off the post. I thought we got a break. But
it's going to be Jack Amundsen.
Hard on the forecheck.
Left wing on the third line right there.
And just
him, oh, Liam Olsen, and Colby Hansen made life difficult in the defensive zone for Cheyenne, and they're rewarded for it. Good hard work and goal. You talk about that first line gets a lot of accolades, and deservedly so. But you want to have depth throughout your lineup. You see the coaching staff there is fired up for that trio of forwards there.
Yeah, all created on an aggressive forecheck.
Just hard work
all
right there.
All three of them touched it, if I'm not mistaken. So, yeah, great effort.
If I'm not mistaken, I think that one even went off a post and deflected in.
Yeah,
so
I thought it was going to go. I thought we caught a break there. Oh,
so now you get back to your comment. What do you lose? Lose 8-0 or lose 4-0?
Yep.
Now you got to really got to take whatever type of chance that you possibly can. I don't know how they're going to create offense when you have this unit out here right now, 8-22
right.
and 5, that they're going to have the puck probably half the shift that they're out there.
Yeah. And,
Amundsen gets the goal, and then both his line mates get rewarded, Hansen and Olsen for the Spartans.
Yeah. So if North can continue to play this way, they are going to be difficult for other teams to contend with. And I don't know if they just have Cheyenne's number. You know, we go back to the game where Cheyenne manhandled South. And then 2 days later, right, South beats North.
Yeah.
I mean, just certain matchups. But I mean,
well, earlier we talked about that they've been so close and they've been on the doorstep and they've been knocking on the door, just never been able to get let in.
Yeah.
I think if they play the way that they played tonight, I wouldn't be surprised if on Friday night that they have a happy bus ride back home to Fargo. It's going to be tough to do it. I mean, they're probably going to be playing, it's like maybe Grand Forks Central if that score holds. We'll have to check a little bit later here in our broadcast, but yeah, they've looked like a state tournament team, at least to me tonight, Sean.
Yeah, absolutely. All right, 5:35 remaining. Cheyenne still looking to get on the board here. Just sticks and lanes. It's been a dominant effort tonight by the Spartans. Oh, Saint off a stick. All right. Looks like we caught a break here. See if we can capitalize on it. All right, Mustangs not able to keep it in. The kind of story of the game. Day late and a dollar short right now. All right, we'll watch the knee. All right, North coming in. Red nicely on the plate. Good job of standing his ground though. Christensen winds up, shot. Nice shot, blocker side. Believe that Mr. Parker Dosh got a piece of that one. All right. Mustangs playing with a little bit of sense of urgency right now. 4 and change to go. Got a proud team here. Want to finish on a positive note. Gunnar Endre is trying to head that man up. Oh. Alone in the slot for a second, that would block nicely, but Mustangs able to read that play. Liam Olsen headmanned up off the stick and blocker by Mr. Jaden Beater. Maddox Watson gonna wind up. Oh, almost snuck through there.
Yeah.
Beater wasn't
from
sure where it was
for a
second.
From the angle we're looking at right there.
From a distance out, it's like, he's got this. Like,
and we see it right there. Nice,
yeah.
Shot by our camera crew and our producer here, Hannah Barger, tonight, doing a fantastic job. You got Tristan Marak also doing some producing. We have Drake Nostrom and Bo Beam and Daxton Fry. So we got a good crew here tonight.
Hats off to them. Well, they were handpicked, right?
Absolutely.
For tonight's assignment. You just Not just walking off the street. Oh,
would have been a high stick there.
We're not counting that one, but nice hand-eye coordination.
So looking at some scores here, Sean, that 3-1 score at Farmers Union, it still holds right now. Game is not final. It's in the third period. 5-2 score, GFC, so Central over Davies. Kind of a surprising score. As of 8 minutes ago, there was 10-12 left in the third, 5-3 Red River over Devil's Lake. So
hanging in there.
Devil's Lake is not going to be a tough out, and 3:33 left here. Coach Benson's going to pull Beater. I apologize. I mean, he got you, right? I mean,
you got him, man. Make a statement here.
You got to get some sort of push.
You're not going to go down lightly. Let's go down swinging. 3:20 remaining. Six attackers for the Mustangs. All right. You got it. That pass just has to be on the mark. It's not acceptable right now to have errant pass. There we go. Nice little stretch. Oh, nice give and go. But why was the forward not breaking to the net sooner on that one?
Well, now they're going to have to see if they can create some opportunity or some offense. Excuse me, off of a faceoff here in the offensive zone. And one of the things at this point of the game here, faceoffs might. And you're going to have to get in, maybe if you're a winger, you're going to have to dig the puck out because you don't have much time left here.
You're going with the number one line. They're probably licking their chops. They got no goalie and no bad.
Oh, and if you're up 4-0, take as many shots at it as you want.
Yep, you're winning the draws, getting possession. All right, Cooper Klaus. Shot. Oh, right in the breadbasket. I don't know.
I think they take exception to Christensen being in the kitchen of Dosh right there. I'm seeing on our replay right there. I think Christensen's stick maybe inadvertently got deflected. That's the way at least he sees it. Maddox Watson, he sees it another way. He's standing up for Dosh, his goaltender, who so far tonight played a nice game.
Yes. All right, Mustangs looking to get possession. 2:44 remaining. Nice job of keeping that bouncing puck in at the line. A little deflection though. I don't know if that was going in anyways. A little wide. Hard to tell from our vantage point on that one.
I think it most likely probably was, I believe, Sean.
Not a lot of North fans have left, nor Cheyenne to their credit, too. There's still see.
Well, the game started a half hour early, so, I mean, you don't have to beat that curfew like you would for a 7:30 game.
That's right.
You have to stay out a little bit later.
Oh, boy. No, it says I'm going to give it to you. Here we go. Oh, kept it in. Gloved ahead nicely. All right, we're going to knock this down. I'm going to close a hand on him. No, we're good. All right, Christensen. I'm going to bring this one in. He is. Oh, takes a bit of an elbow on that one. All right. We'll stand alone at center. Wait for something to develop. All right, here we go. Oh, nice pass by Cooper. Oh, back door open. Just ran out. And then a pass.
I think Christensen was just a little too, right idea. I believe the net would have been open if he had been just a little bit higher. He just got a little bit too deep, and that's no fault to him. It's just where he was when the pass came to him.
He's on his strong
to
side,
yep,
too.
He was.
Not too bad.
That was talking about chances that Cheyenne has had in the third period. That might be the, who do you got next on there?
All right, my friend.
I'm going to tell you who that is.
Number four.
Ryan Patoli, he got robbed of the 2006 Hobie Baker. Greatest college hockey game I was ever at. He had 4 goals and the crowd chanted, Hobie, Hobie, Hobie.
Nothing.
And he got robbed by Matt Carl. His aunt was my Spanish teacher in high school.
Yes, 49 points, my friend.
Of all time, yep. He got robbed. Matt Carl was really good defenseman for Denver, though. So who else he got to finish it out? We don't have much time here.
Number three, you know him well. He's got a rink named after him.
Hey, hello, welcome to Cliff Fido Purper Arena.
You got it. Number two, looks very ominous there.
Is that I think this might be, is that Tim Jackman?
It is Tim Jackman.
But he, nice. I think he grew up in White Bear Lake, I believe.
Oh, we're not counting that. He couldn't have. There's no way they would allow me to do that. Number
one. Is
this
what you did at work all day, by the way? I'm kind of curious. You
got it's on my prep.
Okay.
Oh, you come on.
Paul Gosted.
Yeah, fun not fact, even close. 231
Him and Ryan
points.
Patolny are cousins, first cousins.
He liked the sin bin, too. 778 in a, yeah, he averaged over a penalty.
He ran a hockey camp in Grafton for a while.
Yeah.
His grandparents are from there.
Good for
his,
him.
Well, his dad grew up there, so yeah.
So, good you want to make it to the show? All you do, okay, get 3 points and you're in the
well,
top eight.
You're making that sound like it's an easy tag. I mean, right. We're not discrediting anybody
no,
at all.
Hey, hey. If you can make it in today's game, my goodness. Right. If Clevin is off the post, they are looking for blood. Are you telling me they don't want another one? North is absolutely not. That's a trip. They're not going to call it. All right, stretch pass here. Cooper Klaus got two Mustangs. Go to the net. Like I could have stopped that without equipment on. Right in the middle of the breadbasket. Goodness. And you had room. There, he was veering off. Kind of this has been the story of tonight. Haven't capitalized on the few opportunities that we had, and North has made us pay for any and every mistake. Don't get me wrong, they came out here.
And they blocked shots like that.
Blocked shots.
And I think that one maybe hit a Mustang. The first one was for sure North.
Oh. Trace Meyer wants that one back. Fanned on the one-timer. All right, Mustangs. Oh, cannot. Desperately trying to get this first goal here.
Maybe we'll just say Doss has a shutout.
Break the shutout. Oh, back door. Oh, good save.
I thought maybe that
way
was
to
it.
Come across on that one. Maybe his best save of the game.
Wow.
Oh, that's not going to make it. All right. 30 seconds remaining here. Cooper Klaus, first one in on it. Sadly, we are losing some of the Mustang Hardy.
Cheyenne, faithful student section that was here.
Dwindling a bit.
Looks like they took their basketball jerseys and went to go find a pickup game somewhere. Mr. Salisbury still representing our administration here, though. Nice to see him here. Yeah, unfortunately. There just wasn't a lot to cheer about tonight from the Cheyenne perspective.
Right. All right. Shot from the point. Oh, there. Oh, and there it is. A stick. It looked like an empty net, and who came across? Mr. Maddox Watson.
The Cheyenne can't
cannot buy
can't
a goal.
Convert on these last two shifts here. I think you just chalk it up to it's not their night offensively.
Right. But the road just got a little harder, right? Looks like we are playing Davies.
Correct.
Finalized.
Double check on that score.
All right. We don't want to discount Davies here. Maybe the comeback game. We're going on the high stick. Yep.
Do not have a final score, but Red River did win. That last check, it was 5-3.
Yep.
I think that was maybe to be expected, but Devil's Lake, a tough out. Certainly
right.
Can't discredit
that.
As we
know.
Grand Forks Central did win 5-2.
Okay.
So we will be playing Fargo Davies. That'll be roughly, I'd say, the first game is at 11, second one is 30 minutes after that. We're looking at maybe a 1:30, 2 o'clock game, and at Farmers Union Arena, we don't have any time on the clock, but Fargo South Shanley is up 3-1 on West Fargo.
Well, they are hearing it, and they deserve it.
Yeah, if you're Coach Klein, that's the performance that you wanted out of your bunch here up on the north side. They played their game to a T. Offense was flowing through Branson, Watson, and Wallen. They converted on the power play to get going early in the game.
Second line scored.
Third line scored. So you got scoring from all your lines. You got scoring up and down your lineup. And then defensively, I thought they were very, very stingy.
Yes.
You can look at the board, and I don't know what they're going to finish with for shots. They mean Cheyenne. They had 24 after two, but it certainly didn't seem like they had 24 opportunities. He had some shots from the outside. Just not a lot of traffic at times around Dosh. Just a game, I thought, throughout the whole game, it's Cheyenne. They were going to finish with 34 shots on net, so it looks like they're going to shoot, at least on the board, 34-31. But it just seemed like, Sean, that they were very disjointed throughout the game. And,
Chasing the game, the whole game.
And passing was sloppy. And, turnovers, especially in that first period. We talked about the turnovers that were created by North, in their, Cheyenne defensive zone. And North, they made life difficult for Cheyenne tonight, that's for sure.
Right. And you know what may have been good passes in other games, today it was just the, partly to do with the effort on the North team. What is like, oh man, this is working in practice. All of a sudden, you have a different beast tonight. You have a team that is hungry, and it showed tonight.
There was a couple of times, Sean, and obviously the fans, it was like a forward was standing along the wall, and he just, turns and throws it like that behind his back, and bam, it's right on the stick of a North player.
Where
and,
ours would and, hit a stick.
Yeah,
or
and it was just like,
and
everything was just, and that's not to say that North was lucky at all.
Right.
But it just, every pass they had, it just clicked and clicked and clicked. And then, for us, it was kind of like we're slogging through the mud a little bit tonight.
Yes.
So, unfortunately, the result of that is going to be a 4-0 loss for Cheyenne tonight. So, pull up our EDC bracket there.
So, what time are we playing and what time is North playing? I would love to see that.
Well, North
game as
is
well.
Going to be playing 30 minutes after the first semi. So, North's going to have the late game on Friday. Cheyenne's going to have in the afternoon, they are going to have the second loser out game. And so, for Cheyenne, one thing is they've been in this spot before. Mm-hmm. Okay, the last two state tournaments they have qualified for without winning this first game. And so, life's been made difficult for them before. Hopefully you can rely on some of that veteran experience that has been to those state tournaments. So Cheyenne is going to play. You said that first game's at 11. That's going to be Devil's Lake. And like I said, we don't have any time on the clock for that game that's taking place at Farmers Union Arena. But I'd assume that game's maybe going to be at 1:30 or so. Well, it's 3-2 now at Farmers Union.
Whoa.
So I really wish we had a clock right now, because that's going to be interesting. But either way, the team that is going to skate away with the victory tonight is going to be Fargo North Spartans. And before we hop off, Sean, I don't know how much we've got to dissect this game anymore, but hats off to our crew for getting us up here and getting us set up. Mr. Knodel, Mr. Thomas did a ton of work throughout the day to make sure that we could broadcast this game. The Fargo North administrations, we see Bo Beam right there, eighth grader from Liberty Middle School that's running our camera. But thank you to the Fargo North administration for getting us set up here and allowing us. And this is a heck of a place to call a game. I was kind of wondering how it was going to work.
Yeah.
I brought my, as you would call it, I brought my toque with me. Nice and warm.
Beautiful.
Wearing sweatshirts. We had a great vantage point of the game.
No one from the north side that gave us a stink eye or anything.
They were in a good mood all night long. As we see Drake Nostrom right there running the other camera. So, again, this is all a student-produced production. So hats off to them for all their work throughout the year. So, Mr. Burke, frustrating night.
Yes.
For the Mustangs, they have
too bad.
Turned off the scoreboard. They are taking down their Fargo North Spartans banner, and I believe. Oh. And what that tells us is they want us to go home. So it's a school night.
The good news is we got 1, 2, 3 days to turn this all around and still punch our ticket to state. So good luck, Stangs. We will be watching from somewhere.
All right. So for a finale for Cheyenne Mustang Media, live from the Coliseum up at Fargo North, for Sean, or Jordan Lutowski.
Sure, I'm Jordan.
That was bad. Yes. So, for Sean Burke, I'm Jordan Lutowski.
And take two.
Yeah, well, we're out.
Good night. There's a
fire takes over. Blood is running, heart is pumping as the battle gets closer. They can say what they want now. Every spotlight, every soundbite, everybody who gave up is just a fuel for wanting him more than anybody against us. They can say what they want now. Cause we'll be screaming now.